Good morning. All right, we're getting ready for our workout today. Make sure you have a good pair of sneakers, a water bottle, some weights, or without weights. You can do these exercises without weights as well. My name is Heidi. We do everything with a timer. I'll keep track of the timer. Our workout today is going to consist of lower body, upper body, a little bit of core work, as well as some cardio and balance. So we have a full body workout coming at you, and I have a little bit of music playing in the background, so I might dance it out. All right, let's start with our warm up. Here we go. Here we go, let's kick our butts, bringing our feet up. I hope that you're all doing well, feeling good, able to get outside and get a little bit of air, fresh air. Today it's a little bit chilly. Hopefully it'll warm up a little bit later. The breeze is a little high this morning. Warming up the legs. Good. A little bit of a squat and up and down. Not going super deep. We're just warming up those quad muscles. As you do your squats, even if they're low, you're still going back. You're not going forward. Back like you're looking for that chair. Keep going up and down. Just warming up those legs. Good. Now we're going to just go into kick. Kicking to the front. Warming up the hamstrings. And moving to the music. Oh yeah, I do this much better with music. Kicking those legs up. Remember, always go at your pace. Don't worry about trying to keep up with me. Go ahead and arm circles, small circles. You're the only one that knows your body, so you're the only one that knows the pace that you can go at. Nice round circles, warming up the shoulders. Go ahead and reverse direction. Good, nice deep breath. Good. Now you're going to bring your hands forward and pull back. Forward and back. So it kind of looks like this in the back. Squeezing your shoulder blades. Warming up those shoulder blades. I feel like it looks a little bit dark. I'm hoping it doesn't. I might have to turn a couple more lights on. Good, let's go back and kick those butts. Bringing those feet up. I was kind of hoping I solved the mystery of it going into dark mode, but I did not, so. You'll see me every once in a while come a little bit close to the screen. That's just so that I can wake up my screen. I'll figure it out sooner or later. All right, this is our second round, so we should be moving a little bit faster, warming up. Good, go into those little bit of squats. You can go a little bit deeper this time. Legs are getting warm, the body's getting warm. Remember, your legs are big muscles. Every time you're using those muscles, the body temperature rises. Good, front kicks. Oh. arm circles. This time, let's go a little bit bigger with those arm circles. Shoulders should be getting nice and warm. Keep going. Go ahead and reverse direction. Make sure you're doing those deep breathing in and out. Good. Arms are forward. You're going to pull back. Forward and pull. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale as you pull back. Warming up. Good, nice deep breath. Exhale. One more time. Big breath. And exhale. Beautiful. All right, today we're going to do our lower body first, and then we will do our balance. So let me get the right timer for our lower body. All right, again, we're going to have four exercises for lower body. We're going to start with, you're going to right reverse, stand, and then right front, and then stand. So we're staying on that right side. I'll do left so that it looks like we're doing the same. Let's see if I can just, if I turn this light on a bit, if that helps any, or if it makes it darker. I don't know if that helps. All right, hold on. Make sure you're getting a drink of water. Your right foot is going to step back, then it's going to step forward. We'll do it together. Here we go. Step back, lunge, tap, forward, lunge. So when you're lunging, your knee, I'll go this side, step back, both knees bend, you come up, tap it together, that same leg comes forward, both knees bend, back together, step back, bend, keep going, front, back, front, and back. Go as low as you feel comfortable. Your front foot, the weight should be evenly distributed. Good, rest, shake it out. We're going to go over to the other side. Other side in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, step back, lunge, tap the feet, step forward, lunge, tap the feet, keep going. I have to say, you guys are helping me because I am struggling with being in the house all day with not much to do. I have a two-bedroom condo. It's pretty much as clean as it's gonna ever get. And as my husband said, I'm an anti-hoarder, so I don't even have a lot of stuff to go through to kind of clean up my closets. Keep going. So, good, rest. It's helping me to do this because it keeps me motivated as well. All right, our next move is the sumo squat. Feet out nice and wide. You're actually pointing your toes out to the side. You're gonna go down into a squat and then come up. Again, go as low as it feels comfortable for you. That may be right here and then back up. Or maybe it's way down low. You have to find what works for you. working your quad muscles, your hips, your gluteus medius is the outside. Up and down, keeping your chest up, eyes up. Good, rest. Shake that out. Now what we're gonna do is down a regular squat, so feet are hip width. You're gonna come down, halfway up, back down, all the way up. You got this, this is challenging, but you got it. Here we go. Down, halfway up, back down, all the way up. Down, halfway, down, all the way up. You got it. Squeeze. Quad muscles should be firing. Woo! Halfway, all the way. Remember, do what you can do. It doesn't matter as long as you're moving your body. Almost there. Good, shake it out. All right, that is our first round of lower body. How'd that feel? Legs feel good? All right, before we do round two of lower body, we're actually gonna go do our balance. Make sure you have a chair nearby, just in case you need it. Remember, if you have the chair, don't completely depend on the chair. Have it there just in case you need it, all right? Our first, let me just see if I can put it back there so you can see more of me without me moving back. All right, so the first move, standing on your right foot, your left foot is gonna lift and lower. Lift and lower. Ready? Here we go. Lift and lower. Have the chair if you need the chair, but make sure to let go of it every once in a while so that you're really challenging your balance. Also, remember, the leg that you're standing on, there's that slight bend to the knee. Never lock out the knee. Tapping down or not tapping down. Good, rest. Shake it out. We're gonna go over to the other side. Dance it out. All right, here we go, other side. Lift, lower. You got it. Good. Shake that out. Now we're going to draw that circle on the outside. Here we go. Play your flute. Little circles. You can tap down or you can skip the tap down depending on how advanced you are. The leg you're standing on, slight bend to that knee. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Almost there. Good, shake it out. Should be feeling it. Now we still have that second round of lower body coming up too. Other side, round, little circles. Here we go. Little circles, you should be feeling this. Maybe in the hip, the gluteus medius muscle, the maximus, quad muscle. Small circles. Good, rest. We only have one more for each side. Next one is just holding. You can hold low. You can even do this. Kind of lean just to see if you can lift it. Go ahead. Lift it here. Lift it low. If you're really talented, lift it out to the side. Just kidding. Just be standing on one leg. Slight bend of that knee. Remember, the knee's soft. Don't lock it. You want to protect those joints. Good. Shake that out. Moving over to the other side. Last balance move. Ready? Lift. Again, you can hold the ear of the opposite side of the leg that's up. That is supposed to help you with your balance. You can also put your hand in your belly button, the opposite hand. Somehow that's supposed to help with your balance. Make sure you're focusing on something that doesn't move. That's extremely helpful. Good, shake it out, beautiful. All right, we're gonna move into the second round of that lower body. How are you feeling? Remember, you can pause this at any time. Pause it. If you don't wanna do the second round, you can fast forward through the second round. That's cheating. No, just kidding. But if you're only ready for one round right now, that's okay, just do the one round. All right, I'm gonna get a drink of water here. Before we start round two of lower body, do you remember what that first move was? It was step back, lunge, tap, step forward, lunge, and tap. Okay, so I'm gonna take a sip of water. Hopefully you can hear me over the music. I'm gonna just turn it down one more little spot here. All right, how are you guys feeling? Good? Right? I'm feeling good. I'm very thankful that we're able to do this. I miss seeing your faces and hearing your voices, but we're doing the best we can with the tools we have right now, right? All right, let's do it. Step back, lunge, bring them back together. Same foot now goes forward instead of back. Lunge, bring the feet together, step back, same side. Forward. You may find that one side has a little bit more balance than the other. It's perfectly normal. You want to make sure when you step forward, I'm going to turn it this way. When you go forward, you're going down and up. You're not doing this. See how that knee goes forward? It's a down and up like a carousel. Last one. And rest. All right, now we move to the other side. All right, other side. Step back first, here we go. Back, lunge, together, forward, lunge, bring it back together. Same side, keep going. Remember, go as low as you feel comfortable. Front knee stays over your ankle. The knee doesn't go over the toes. Inhale and exhale. If you want this to be more advanced, you could always have weights in your hands. That's going to add a little bit more resistance. Almost there, last one. Good. Step it in, shake it out. Now we go into that sumo, legs nice and wide. And just make sure that stays lit. Legs nice and wide, toes are pointed out. You come down with your chest and eyes forward, come up and squeeze. Down, squeeze. Now if you're too close together, see what happens there? My knees will end up going over my toes. You want to make sure your feet are far enough out. Even if you're only coming down a little bit, your knees still aren't going over your toes. If you feel more confident, you can always have that chair in front of you while you do this. Good. Good. Shake that out. How those legs feeling? We have that one more exercise. That's the squat, half squat, and then full squat. Feet hip width apart. So you go down into the squat, halfway up, back down, all the way up. Here we go. Down, halfway, down, all the way. I'm going to do it this way so that you can see. I go back, halfway, back down, all the way up and squeeze. Down, halfway, down, all the way up and squeeze. Keep going. This should be really warming up those quad muscles. Whew. This is your last lower body. Good. Shake it out. It's beautiful. Go ahead and get a drink. We're going to move into upper body. Strengthen those arms and shoulders. All right. Either with weights, if you have weights. If you have water bottles, full water bottles, they weigh the same thing. So you could use those absolutely for these exercises. Anything that has two that are the same weight, basically. All right, I'm gonna grab my weights. Our first exercise is gonna be the hammer curl. Working the bicep muscle, but this is the different angle of the bicep instead of our regular. We're gonna actually have our palms turned in like so. Down here, we come up, we come down. So it looks like this, elbows nice and tight to the side, come up to the shoulders, full range of motion is all the way back down. Grab our timer here. All right, grab your weights. Always bending at your knees to pick up your weights. Lift with your legs. All right, first exercise is that hammer curl. Let me see if I should turn to the side here so you can see it. Remember, anytime you're doing upper body, your knees are soft. See how mine are? This is, let me do it here. This is locked out. This is soft, okay? Little bend of the knees. You want to protect your joints. All right, here we go. Exhale as you lift. Inhale as you lower. Good. There we go. Working those biceps. Keep going. Inhale as you lower. Exhale as you lift. I have these adjustable dumbbells. Makes it easy. I don't have to have 52 different sets of weights. The only problem I have is that they're a little bit awkward. Good, rest. Next, what we're going to do is going to do what's called the bent over row. So it looks like this. Again, feet are hip width apart, knees are soft. You hip hinge with both weights in the hand, and then you're going to pull up. And you're squeezing your shoulder blades when you get there. So you stay in this hip hinge, arms come down, squeeze as you come up. Okay? Here we go. Squeeze, inhale, exhale. Keep your core tight so that you're protecting your lower back. That means you're using the muscle to pull your belly button in. Like you're trying to get on a pair of tight jeans, you know that when you pull it in, that's what you want to be doing. Almost there, less than 10 seconds. Lower, squeeze. You're dragging those elbows by your side as you bring it up. Good, rest. Next, you're gonna come up, hands like so, like you're gonna do an overhead press. This time though, you're gonna bring the arms together and then open it up. Ready, here we go. Squeeze, like you're squeezing a beach ball between the elbows. And then bring it back out. Squeeze. back out to shoulder height. You're not going way back, just to shoulders. Squeeze. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. This is working those shoulders. And your biceps are under constant resistance because you're holding. You're not dropping below the shoulders. If it gets to be too much with the weights, put the weight down and continue the move without the weight. Good, rest. Next, you're gonna go back into that hip hinge position, but this time you're gonna have those weights here. You're gonna lift to shoulder height and bring it back down. Ready, knees soft, hip hinge, pull that core in, arms slightly with a slight bend of the elbows. Here we go, lift, lower, lift, lower, inhale as you lower, exhale as you lift, inhale. This is called the reverse fly. Again, go as high as you feel comfortable. Maybe you don't get to shoulder height, that's okay. Just go as wide as you can, controlling it. Make sure gravity doesn't bring those back down, you do. Good, rest. How you feeling, good? All right. Shake it out. Woo-hoo. Get a drink. We're gonna move into cardio. Cardio. We love cardio. Get that heart rate pumping. All right. Two exercises. They're 20 seconds each. 10 second rest in between, and we do four rounds. So the first one, I like doing the side-by-side jacks. This is a good one. Get your heart going. All your limbs are moving. That'll be our first one. The next one is speed skate. The purpose of the cardio is to get your heart rate up. So if you're doing this and your heart rate is up, that's wonderful. But if you're doing this and you're able to have a full conversation and it doesn't really feel like your heart's pumping much faster than it was just standing there, then you need to move a little bit faster, okay? It's all about the cardio here. This is the cardio exercise part of it. We want to get that blood pumping through the heart, okay? Side-by-side jacks, 20 seconds. Ready? Here we go. Side to side. Don't overthink it. Good. Shake that out. We're going to go into that speed skate, 10 seconds of that speed skate. Make it what works for you, right? Side to side, here we go. Step, step, here we go. I definitely work out much easier when there's music. Definitely more motivating for me. Good, rest. All right, side to side jacks, round two of four. Here we go. Side to side. If your shoulders are already sore, you could just do the legs. If your legs are bothering you, just do the arms. Good, rest. Gonna go into that speed skate. I just want to make sure this doesn't go into dark mode. 3, 2, 1, speed skate. This song, don't worry about a thing. Don't you worry about a thing. All right, my speed skate looks more like a dance, but either way, heart is moving, right? It does not matter what you're doing as long as the body is moving. All right, we're going into round three of four, side-to-side jacks. Good, rest. Speed skate. Three, two, here we go. Don't you worry about a thing. Worry about a thing. Good. Catch your breath. Last round of our cardio. Last round, get that heart pumping. Side to side, here we go. Go at your pace. You don't have to try and keep up with me. Just move. Good, shake it out. Last round, speed skate, two, one, skate. Good. Walk it out. Beautiful. Finish the cardio. All right. We have one more round of upper body. Those same four exercises. You want to shift now with a different weight if you have different weights, or do these without any weight at all. You can still use the muscle without using weights. I'm going to get a sip of water. A breath. Let's take a nice deep breath. Exhale. One more time. Nice deep breath. This is a workout, but we also want to make sure that we take a minute to just slow down and appreciate where we are at this moment. Be grateful that we're able to do these workouts, that we have the ability to move our bodies, even if it's only half the body. We're still able to move and just energize and feel good. All right, let's get into that second round. Hammer curl. Remember, this is the one where your palms, let me put the weights down. Your palms are facing each other. Instead of this, they're doing this, and you're curling up and down. Okay? Here we go. Exhale as you lift. Inhale as you lower. Watch the body. See how it's nice and straight and I'm not swinging it? If you're doing this, get your weights up. They're too heavy. Go with a lighter weight. Put the weights down. Do it without the weight. Nice and slow and controlled. You control it up. You control it down. Nice and slow. Good, rest. Now we go into that row. We're lean over. I like this song. I'm going to turn it up a little bit. All right, you lean over. You're going to squeeze it up. Here we go. Core is nice and tight. Squeeze it up. Like you're picking up something with your back when you shouldn't. Drag those elbows by your side. Good. exhale as you lift it, inhale as you lower it, pulling your core in nice and tight. Good. All right, now we do that shoulder move. Coming up like we're gonna do the shoulder press, except for this time we're squeezing it together. Ready? Here we go. And then open it. Squeeze. Open only to shoulders. You wanna be holding it up here, don't have it down here, that's too much on your neck. Gotta have it right here. Put the weight down if it's too much. Boy, the shoulders are feeling it, huh? Woo! House. Good, rest. Last upper body move, you're going back to that bent over position, hip hinging. Arms are nice and straight with a slight bend to the elbow. You come up and back down. Remember, you're controlling this, up and down. Here we go, up and then down. Don't bring it up and then let it drop down. Don't swing it up and then let it drop down. Slow and controlled up, slow and controlled down. Your eyes should be forward, so your neck is lined up with your spine. Exhale as you lift, inhale as you lower. Almost there. Good, release. Go ahead and put those weights down. Get a drink. We just have a couple of core moves that we're going to do together. All right, we're going to do a couple of core moves together, and then we're going to do our stretching. So the core move, I always like to do plank because plank is something that uses the entire body and strengthens the core. You may want to do this on a chair. So if you're on a chair, your hands go on the chair, you step back, nice straight line still. That is what a chair plank looks like. You're looking forward, you're not looking over or up or under. Nice straight line, okay? Or you can do the plank on the floor. Same thing, hands directly underneath the shoulders, heels go back, squeeze everything. Nice straight line. You're not up here, you're not down here. Everything is a nice straight line. Or drop down to your knees. You can also have a nice straight line here. All right? We have 35 seconds. Let me make sure that they're ready. Here we go. 35 seconds holding your plank. Make sure you're breathing. Nice deep breath in and out. Legs might be shaking. Core might be shaking. That means it's working. Squeeze the muscles. Almost there. 3, 2, 1, release. Woo. Nice. Last exercise we're going to do is we're just going to flip over on the floor. Hands behind your back. You're going to bring it up. And you're just gonna hold. I want you to be leaning back. If you're in the chair, go ahead and lean back in your chair. Here we go. Bring it up and hold. So more advanced, you might have your hands out here or here. You're not leaning on your hands. I don't want you to lean on your hands. Your hands are there just for a little bit of support. You should be feeling it in the core, right here. If you want, you can straighten the legs. That's more advanced. The lower they are, the ground is advanced, or you can just keep the knees slightly bent. Neck is lined with your spine. You can switch, do one, bring that down, switch, bring the other one up, and then rest. Nice deep breath. How do you feel? That was today's workout. So now we're gonna do some stretching and some cool down, because cool down and stretching is super important. I need you to make sure you understand the importance of stretching after a workout, okay? Don't just do the workout and then leave. Gotta do the stretching afterwards. Let's start with some nice deep breaths. Deep breath in. Exhale. Again, nice deep breath. And exhale. Beautiful. And bring your arm across. It's like you're going to pat yourself on the opposite shoulder, but you keep the arm out straight and the other arm bends it. Make sure the shoulder is away from your ears. You should feel this stretching your shoulder cap. Nice deep breaths. Get that oxygen to those muscles. You guys worked hard today. Whoo, felt good. Good, shake that out. Switching over to the other side. Remember, like you're gonna pat yourself on the opposite shoulder, except for your arm comes out straight. The other one wraps around. Make sure you're not on the elbow, on the forearm. Then drop the shoulder away from the ear. If you want a deeper stretch, you can always look over the shoulder. Good, go ahead and release that. Now what I want you to do is take your hand, put it on your head, bring your ear down to your shoulder just lightly. The opposite hand is gonna reach out like it's looking for something on the table. Now I want you to kind of just shift your chin lower to the floor. And then move the straight arm around until you're feeling that stretch in that neck area. Nice deep breaths. Hold it when you find that good spot. Deep breath. Release the straight hand first, then bring the neck up. Go ahead and look left and right, just to kind of shake it out a little bit. Good, now we're gonna go to the other side. Go ahead and grab the head lightly, bring the ear down. Again, you're not yanking, I don't want you to yank on it, just slightly bring it down. And then the opposite hand comes out. Now your chin goes down towards the floor, and then move that straight arm around till you find the spot. Once you have it, hold the hand there, take a couple deep breaths in and out, and again. Always release the straight arm first, then let the head come up, look left and right. Good, look down. Roll your head to one side, only to the side though, don't go back. And then bring it back down to center. Roll it to the other side. And then bring it back down to center. Again, roll to the side. Try to make sure your shoulders aren't coming up. It's your head that's rolling over. Bring it back to center. Roll. Back to center. Go ahead and lift up. And then look all the way up to the ceiling, nice and slow. Don't drop your head back. And again, kind of just look to the right, and then look to the left. While you're looking up, like you're looking around at the stars, bring it to center, bring that down. Good, hopefully that stretched out some of those muscles that are all around the neck. All right, now we're gonna do the legs. So if you need to, grab a hold of your chair, or if you have something that's close by, grab a hold of that. Something that's stable though. Don't grab a hold of a chair on wheels or a dog that might run off. Once you have that, I want you to step back. Let's see if I can do this over here. Step back, the back leg stays straight. I want you to bend the front leg. I want you to feel that stretch right here. That's in your hip flexor. That right there gets shortened because we sit all day. So we want to make sure we're stretching that out. Nice deep breaths. Bring the arms up. Or bring the one arm up if you're holding onto the chair. Good. Bring that back leg in. Bend that back leg a little bit. Straighten the front leg. Lean over. toes are up on that front leg, stretching the hamstring in the back of the leg. Good, drop that toe down, stand up. Go ahead and step back the other leg. The back leg straight, bend your front leg. Feel that in the hip flexor. Both hands up or one hand up. The hand that goes up is the one that has the leg back. Good. Bring that back leg in. Bend the back leg a little bit, slightly. Straighten the front leg. Toe comes up. Lean on over. Stretch that hamstring. Hope you guys enjoyed today's workout. Thank you again for checking in, pushing play, doing the best that you can in this crazy situation we have going on right now. Go ahead and release that toe. Go ahead and stand up. Only 17. All right, legs apart. My last and final stretch is my favorite one. Legs apart. Nice deep breath. I'm going to do it this way so that you can see what I mean by when I say flat, flat, flat back. Here we go. Deep breath. As you exhale, come to that flat back. So now your legs are straight because I want you to feel that in the hamstring, but also notice my back. You could put a glass of water here and it's not going to spill because it's nice and flat. You can hang the arms. You can have the arms here. Don't put them on your knees. If you feel comfortable enough and confident enough, try to reach for the floor. Bring your head down. Your neck. Again, only if you feel comfortable. Keeping the legs straight, because this is what we're stretching. We're stretching the back of those legs and the lower back. Now, before you start rolling up, I want you to bend your knees first and then roll up one vertebrae at a time. And then once you're up, dance it out. I don't know if you can hear it. Let's see. The time of my life. Thank you guys for tuning in. Have an awesome day. God bless.